When Nasty C signed a deal with Def Jam, many people thought that the wave and movement sparked by Nasty C had come to an end. With the common and popular stereotype against major record label, majority of people thought Nasty C signed a slave deal. But ever since he signed a deal with Def Jam, his career has only elevated to greater heights. This is more evident after the release of his first album with Def Jam, Strings and Bling. Welcome to Hip Hop with Prosper. Please subscribe and like this video. Let's get to it. Watch this entire video, as I will be breaking down the entire financial breakdown with proof of this $10 million ordeal. On the February 16, 2018, Nasty C signed his first deal with Universal Music Africa, in partnership with Universal Music South Africa, under the Def Jam imprint. On the 1st of June, he also signed another deal with Universal Music Group Nigeria, before the pre-release of his singles Jungle and King, which feature American rapper A$AP Ferg. Now at this point, both of these deals were just distribution deals, with the support of a major record label. The biggest advantage of this would be having his music widely spread throughout the continent. It allows him to work with experienced people, with endless connections. So how exactly did Nasty C make over $10 million from one album? On the 6th of July 2018, Nasty C released his much-anticipated album, Strings and Bling, on both digital and physical formats. This album was distributed through Universal Music Africa. Universal Music has a huge network when it comes to radio and streaming services. This allows artists' songs to be massively spread. The more spread the song or album has, the bigger its chances of the song or album to reach more emerging fans. It gets more exposure, making the artist's song or album to be in more demand. The higher the demand, the higher the music sales as well as streams. And this is what happened to Nasty C. Universal Music Group has a lot of data regarding artist. This makes marketing and promoting the artist much easier. Through their database, they are able to see which artists have the same, or more or less the same affinity score. And this allows the record label to market their artist to the other artist with a similar affinity score. To give a more practical example of the above statement, let's take three artists: Nasty C, Shane Eagle and Aries. They all emerged around the same time. What record labels will do is, they will market Nasty C music through social media and other avenues targeting Shane Eagle or Aries fan based through their demographics. They know that this method will work due to the affinity score acquired through stats. Now back to Nasty C. Let's do the breakdowns. It was reported that Nasty C's String and Bling album went triple platinum. Now in South Africa, the equivalent amount required for an album to be recognized as platinum is 15,000 units sold, while gold is only 10,000 units sold. This simply means that Nasty C sold over 45,000 units. The standard price of one album in South Africa is 150 rands. So 150 times 45,000 equals 6,750,000. It was also reported that all songs on the album were certified gold, platinum or triple platinum. The standard price for one song in South Africa is 10 rands. 13 songs are certified gold, while two were certified platinum, and one song was certified 3x platinum. 13 gold singles, times 10 rands, times 10,000, equals 1,300,000. Money made from gold singles. Two platinum singles, times 10 rands, times 15,000, equals 300,000 rands. One triple platinum single would equal 450,000 rands. The amount of money made from digital and physical sales of the album would amount to 8,800,000 rands. More money was made from streams. The album received over 20 million streams. Artists get paid $5,000 for 1 million streams. 5,000 times 20 million streams equals $100,000. Converted to the South African rand, that equates to 1,500,000. From streams and physical and digital sales, The album made over 10,300,000 rands. Since this was a distribution deal, the royalty split is usually around 20-30% after all expenses have been paid and all the money is recouped. This album was followed up with the Ivy Sun tour, which sold over 16,000 tickets. The tour allegedly made over 3,200,000 rands. But all that money wasn't profit. You have to consider other expenses such as guest artist, venue rentals, taxes and way much more, like dancers, videographers, etc. From the album sales, featured artists, writers, producers, engineers, also have to get a cut or royalties. There's also the government, and they require taxes. Since then, Nasty C has signed a joint venture deal with Def Jam. This simply means that both companies, Def Jam and Nasty C, Tall Racks record label, join forces. They do this by sharing resources. In this case, Nasty C brings in the music and talent, while Def Jam takes care of the promotion, marketing, sales and overall cost of the production. Once the project is complete and released to the public, Def Jam will recoup all the money they spent, and the remaining profit is then later split between the two companies. Now, since these deals are not disclosed to the public, this was a special episode of Pocket Watching. Yes, man. Let me know in the comments section of this video if I have left anything out. Please do subscribe and like the video, as I will be releasing more videos exposing the music industry. Follow me on my social media at Hip Hop with Prosper on Instagram, and at Hip Hop by Prosper on Twitter, to stay up to date with everything that's going on within the entertainment space. Stay safe and take care.